Ladies and gentlemen, come gather round, come gather round, come gather around. Today, we're taking a look at BestArc's plasma cutter. I'm looking forward to seeing how this one goes. Let's give her.
So I remember when I got my first plasma cutter, I paid probably the cheapest price I could probably get off of eBay. Brought it home, plugged it in, it did not explode. And I used it to do a fair amount of fabrication for my 61 Chevy pickup. This guy looks intriguing. So this was sent to me. I'm going to give it a go. One of the things that I like about this is it comes with a pilot arc. There are plasma cutters where they're like a drag tip, and the tip has to stay in contact with the metal. This one uses a pilot arc, and you don't have to stay in contact, and nor really should you be in contact with the metal that you're trying to cut. And in theory, the tips last longer. So, nevertheless, we're going to give this a go. Plasma cutters with a pilot arc tend to be a little bit pricier, but I'm intrigued. Haven't heard of this brand before, but I'm going to have a look. One of the things I often do with products that I get is I take a pokey poke inside. I have no idea what I'm looking at, but we're going to have a look.
Ooh, that's colorful. I confess, once again, I don't know what I'm looking at, but I'm looking to see if it looks presentable. Like, if you didn't care, you would hack this thing all together. But good heat sinks, nice little shield, cooling fan, lots of circuitry, surface mount. If you're an electrical engineer, leave a comment below telling me what you see, because I don't know. Certainly nice. I like the crowns. But I think it's required. Solenoid for air. Push to click. Tidy. Certainly simple circuitry. I'd like to see a zap strap on here, like they have at the other end, and I will likely put one on just cuz, but honestly, it's not going to go anywhere once it's in the case. But it couldn't hurt to have another. I like that they put stickers in here. So someone either looked at it or someone just put stickers on it. Kind of cool.
So it looks all right from the inside. It goes together fairly well. I did not have to take the handle off for this. Thought I did, but nope. It's not that heavy a unit, so you don't really need to have a handle screwed to some reinforcement inside. I love the color. It's got like a late 50s kind of vibe to it, which is a natural pastel. Duty cycle is important on a machine. If you're going to run full throttle with this, you can only get 60% duty cycle. But if you're willing to knock the power down like 75-80% of full throttle, you can get 100% duty cycle. So 34.9 amps on 220 would do you.
This is an M fitting, which is the most common type of fitting, which is fine. But I use this one, a V fitting, which is significantly more flow. So that's the one I'm putting on. If you have the choice, run 220. Good length whip. That's pretty robust. It's got a ball and socket on the end, which is kind of cool. Security switch. These are good because it keeps you off the metal the right height. This should be removable. And I can see it's been used. So at least somebody made sure that it worked.
So I always want to take a look and see inside, partly because I want to know, and how easy is it to change the tips on this? And the tips are a little different than I've seen before. I just use my Welper MIG pliers to get in there and have a look.
So 2T, you pull the trigger, it cuts, you let go of the trigger, it stops cutting. 4T, you touch the trigger, it cuts, you touch the trigger to shut it off. PT adjusts how much air comes out of the tip after you finish your cut. That's kind of handy. Not sure what a good number is, but I'm going to pick 5. Why 5? That's an odd number. And then air, it just blows air out of there, which would be cool. I've never needed a feature with that, but that could be kind of cool. Looks like we've got dials here depending on what voltage you're on. 30 to 50 PSI, and we've got a gauge. Sorry, 30 to 60 PSI on 220. I guess we could hit this. Oh, that's probably why. Let's talk PPE for a minute. The fumes coming off a plasma cutter are not good for you at all. My other plasma cutter, well, all plasma cutters I've used in my shop, I don't know what it is about the stuff coming off, the smoke, but my smoke detector in my shop goes frickin' berserk, even though it's in a cupboard, covered by a tin can to try and stop it from going berserk. If my smoke detector doesn't like it, my lungs probably don't either. So you definitely want to protect your lungs. I'm going to be protecting my gloves with my hands inside them. Shh.
Your eyes will thank you if you have some of these green tint goggles for oxyacetylene. I think they're a number 5 tint.
Wow. Half inch. I pretty much never cut half inch. And I'm impressed. The last plasma cutter I tested could not do half inch. This cut half inch. Wow, it cut half inch. Huh. Holy crap, that's cool. What about something thin? This will probably be 18 gauge. Whoa. I just noticed I cut half inch on setting 35. All right, now I want to try it now. Oh, holy. So I put the BestArc plasma cutter to work on some 18 gauge, some quarter inch plate, and some half inch steel, and was impressed that this thing cut through half inch without really causing a fuss. That's pretty cool. Granted, it was on 220 volt, but all machines work better on 220. I was impressed. This thing did a nice job. The torch feels pretty reasonably robust. The ground is kind of like any other that you've seen on a machine. The tips are a little different than what I'm used to seeing, but I'm sure you can get replacement tips. The lengths of the cords are good, the whole unit's pretty light, but the quality of the cut was decent. The power of it seems pretty good. It wasn't on full throttle to do half inch, and that was impressive. But it comes with a pilot arc, which you need to have if you want to do CNC plasma cutting. Now, I fully intend to put this to work on a CNC table. I don't have one yet. There's a couple I'm looking at getting. I'll probably purchase them unless some company wants me to try one out. You will see this unit going on a CNC plasma table in the near future. When? Don't know. We'll get there. But color me impressed. I'm impressed with this. So if this unit intrigued you, there's a link in the description down below where you can check out one of these and see how well it'll tantalize your creative juices. So, as always, thanks for watching. Take care. And we'll see you again. I got some more plasma stuff to think up.